Hello. So we're going to share with you today how we leverage on APIs to deliver artificial intelligence as a service. First, I need to introduce the playground of AI. When we talk about AI within BNP Paribas, we talk about unstructured data because it's massive. First, 80% of the world's data is unstructured. So basically, it's free text that you can find in any kind of documents. It can be emails, contracts, news, chat, procedures. It can also be voice records, so not only text but voice, or images. And I think it's the first time of history that all this data is digitized, meaning stored in the same format that can be read and understood by machines. So you can teach them to extract specific data points from any of these documents. And for us, the purpose is really to reduce the number of repetitive and administrative tasks of our teams and refocus them on client relationship and innovation. The second element is that AI, basically, is making the transition from a research topic to enterprise adoption. So web giants and academic laboratories have made significant progress over the past year, and they publish a lot of papers. And these papers are being implemented in open source libraries that any of us can use to deliver AI. And we've seen a number of industries being truly transformed with AI. We know the self-driving cars industries. A few years ago, it didn't exist. Now, it's a reality. And today, the software that equipped the car is as important as the engine. The health industry also is another good example on medical imagery, where AI combined with medical experts can really provide unprecedented performance. So now, back to the financial industry. I don't think the transformation is so deep and radical in the banking industry, but still, we have a huge number of use cases at BNP Paribas, so at group level. We have listed 250 AI use cases across the group. So in terms of absolute figure, I don't know if it's big or not, but what you have to know is that 3 years ago, this figure was down to zero. So the acceleration of AI adoption at BNP Paribas is really growing fast. And we can see that it's taking place in every part of the organization. So every métier, of course, and every functions. Can have some examples on customer experience. We use sentiment analysis to better measure and improve client satisfaction. On operational efficiency, we can parse our client instructions received by emails, fax, or chats, and seamlessly execute the orders on our platforms. On risk mitigation, we work on anti-money laundering and anti-fraud to cross multiple unstructured sources and spot, detect abnormal patterns. We also use AI on cybersecurity and to meet regulatory demands. how we deliver AI. So basically, we started with a search engine. So it's not very original, but it's very important because it's the only way to reassemble, regroup, to say it in other words, to break the silos and index all the knowledge of the bank. So all unstructured data, wherever they are, share drive, SharePoint, intranets, we index the content from everywhere it comes, and then we rank the results with a certain level of relevancy, hopefully. And by doing this, we create a massive knowledge base, okay, which is very important, and we refocus data producers on content production. They no longer need to care about distribution. Distribution is providing through the search bar. And then they refocus on data quality, metadata around their content, and content itself. So this is very important because it creates an ecosystem to aggregate unstructured data and build knowledge base. And then this search becomes an API, because within the search, we have a full stack, pretty complex, pretty technical, and we offer it to other business applications or client applications that need a search within their own application domain. So the search is provided through a web interface for all employees, but also as an API for any application, we don't know them, that need a search to be offered to their clients. I'll give you an example. At Global Markets, we produce a lot of research for our clients, for markets clients. This research is accessible in a website, and they need a search to index correctly the content so that clients can find instantly what they're looking for. So this is an example of how we build AI. And then on this platform of knowledge, we build up additional features. So I'll take a couple of examples. One is translation, or maybe it's not the most impressive one, but it's very tangible. Translation, we work on translation first because we have a presence in more than 70 countries. So it's really huge. We have very technical document to translate because it's contracts, it's corporate actions, it's procedures, it's law text. It's very specific and technical. And also, we have to protect our client interests and client privacy. So for these reasons, we cannot go, or we decided not to go, for external solutions or cloud solutions. And by doing it internally, we build expertise. So we've used an open source deep learning algorithm that we train on our specific data so that we can have better performance when compared to external solution. And also, cost-wise, it's cheaper. So these are the benefits of implementing translation within the bank for our specific use cases. And then users can use it on the interface, but they can also consume the API and plug the API in any of their business applications as well. Can plug it in Outlook if they wish. They can really integrate the API wherever they want. Another example is speech. It's close to translation because we have huge amount of records stored of, for instance, our traders' conversations with clients. And today this is not used, but by using speech to text, we can transcript the record and then do NLP on the transcript. And then we can work on client satisfaction, conduct, whatever. And again, on speech, within the bank, most of us speak English with a very French accent, like I do today. And this is why outside solutions are not very good at transcription of our speech. So this is why we engage more and more in building these bricks, very elementary bricks, and push them as APIs for any kind of use case. Another example is on the named entity recognitions. You know, entities recognitions and entities disambiguation is a very large topic in AI. A lot of progress made on this. And so we work on it to screen contracts. So, you know, whenever we write a contract, we have to screen the names against vigilance lists or sanctions lists. So we have contracts of 500 pages in some cases. It's complex contracts, specialized financing, and we have to spot in these contracts all people names, company names, country names, city names, addresses. And this can be automatically extracted by engines, and then our teams, they perform their checks, their compliance checks, with this first part being automated. So these are illustrations of on what we do with AI and how we deliver AI in the bank. Now, if we can move to the next page. Bon. Régie. Marche plus.
Stuck. Bon.
If you can switch to next slide, please. Yes, thank you. So now, why do we use APIs? APIs, we use it for to create standards first. So in AI, you need to build standards. The most traffic you have on your API, the smarter your engine becomes. You have to concentrate and aggregate the flows in one place. If you duplicate, if you replicate, you lose value. So it's really important to have one place where our users will consume the brick. So it helps us to create the standard. Then the service, the objective, obviously, is to enable any developer or user or application to access the service seamlessly. So it's open API. They can quickly sign up. And we have a dev portal that enables us to onboard all users without too much work on our side. So service is very important. Then security, APIs is end-to-end security by design. So we use OAuth to authenticate the application that consumes the API and propagate the authentication until the backend. And lastly, scalability. So scalability is very important. We work on the private cloud of BNP Paribas CIB. We have containers, and we scale up. So whenever the traffic requires it, we scale up the containers on virtual machines as much as we need. So this is basically technically why we use APG on this part. More fundamentally, for us, APIs is a way to reconnect business with IT. This is very important. Over time, we may have, in some places, IT segregated from business. It's a new way of working, which is open and flat. Open because it creates platforms that interconnect together through APIs. And flat because it values more collaboration and expertise rather than hierarchies and structures. So this is also a way to engage our team that feel much more empowered and recognized for what they do.
Well, it's true that for Hugues, which was really important, was to build this service. After, of course, APIs, and you describe it, for an IT department and for IT guys, it's quite important, quite easy to use. It will be scalable, flexible. But we should look at the next step and what we try to achieve there. And clearly, it will be, because APIs is just a mean, but behind APIs, what we try to reach is the how we will connect customers, how we will serve the customers, ultimately. And that's the first time we are able to connect all the different layers to improve and to bring value to the customers. So for doing so, we think inside the bank, but also we have many discussions externally, we think that we should be organized as a market, an open digital market. So it doesn't work anymore. So can you move on? Yes. On this market, there is two axes, the north-south and the east-west. On the north-south, as you described, what we're going to try to do is to connect people, actually what we could call economic agents. So it can be IT guys, it can be consumer, it can be producer. And we want to connect them to the resources. It can be PaaS, IaaS, IT capacity. It can be knowledge, because we will exchange knowledge in the future in a more automated way. It can be code. It will be everything you will need to build a service and a product. And you have the second axe. The second axe is the east-west, where to build such a capability and such a service, you will have also to build platform to enable the different design thinking implementation. And also, you will need the business value, the data, and potentially the different services offered externally outside the bank or even in other corporations. All around is going through the marketplace. There is one unique marketplace, or at least we would like to have only one single marketplace. It will be a B2B2C approach, meaning that it's a kind of fractal and reusable component. Everything you can build through the platform using some resources, calling some people. And when it's done, you can expose the product to the community inside the marketplace and make it again and again like that. Alors, that's the first step. What is the next step? Because we are already thinking to the next step. The next step, actually, is to get rid of the marketplace. And as you could see, all the marketplace and all the connection was using APIs. So now what we want to do is to connect all the APIs all together. And for doing so, we will need the AI capability. And we will need to have a kind of automatic or auto-discovery methodology or autonomous APIs. So by doing so, we will introduce piece by piece a kind of dynamic information system where for a specific purpose, we will be able to build on fly a product, a set of products or services, and even a small part of a, let's say, temporary information system to serve the business in a specific way. That's what we try to achieve. I think there will be this afternoon several sessions about AI for APIs, and I think that's the next step of the transformation. Thank you very much.
Thank you.